Time again for our Diggin-In series with the Valley Today's Christy Larson.
This morning, she's been talking with the experts at Baker Garden and Gift in South Fargo about the very, very popular container gardening, just perfect for all those people who live in apartments. Christy.
Good morning, Kyle and Lisa. That's right. Live in apartments, or maybe you even started doing it in your own backyard on your front step. Containers, as Phaedra's been telling me, are very popular. Your own yard has all containers.
Yes, I essentially exclusively garden in containers, various sizes, various different things. You don't necessarily need a pot that you've purchased at a garden center to have a container garden. You can plant in anything. I'm a firm believer that if you can drill a hole in it, you can plant in it. That includes wash tubs, old stew pots, anything that you can get a hole into the bottom for drainage, you can plant in. So today I've chosen just a simple garden center container, and we've started with some good quality potting mix, which is available multiple brands. I prefer our Baker mix. It's an excellent potting soil. You want to see that clumping. You want to see it sort of fall apart, but yet hold together. Now we have got a really good moisture level. The next thing we need is to start with a slow release fertilizer, Christy.
Okay.
Want to add a couple scoops?
I said I wanted to feed the plants, so I was going to do this myself.
Yeah. And this is a slow release fertilizer that's going to feed for about 3 months. So 2 scoops is appropriate for this size of a container. So I'm going to work it into the top levels. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to start with my plants. You need to choose an appropriate number for plants for containers. That's important to get yields out of something this size.
Yeah.
So what I'm doing is I'm doing a tomato. This is a Tumbling Tom Red, which is a cherry tomato that trails. You can already see there's a tomato on it.
Yep.
You want to loosen up the root ball. That's important. I always tell people if you had to live in a little small container that size, you would want to stretch out too.
You want to get loose.
So I'm going to put this on the edge because this isn't going to be the highest thing in my container. It is going to trail off. So I've put that on the edge. I've tamped the soil down around it. Mm-hmm. The next thing I'm going to put in is because I love caprese salad, so I am going to put basil in with my tomatoes.
And that goes on the edge too?
This goes a little closer to the middle. Surprisingly, this amount of basil is going to get substantial.
Now, I know we're kind of running out of time, so we can, as you can hear, have a lot more to tell you throughout this morning. We're going to be telling you many more tips on how to do container gardening. As you said, Kyle, it's become very popular, no matter if you're in an apartment, maybe in a house. We're going to be showing you much more coming up throughout the morning.
Christy Larson reporting live for us. Thank you, Christy.